Good morning. The multi number of subscribers wanted to know whether a will could be executed in favor of the third parties, or whether how to disprove the will, whether will should be probated or letter of administration should be obtained compulsorily, and how to disprove the will and how to get share of their property. For all that, I want to discuss with you. Number one, I has already several times told there are two kinds of will. Number one, privileged will. The other one is unprivileged will. Privileged will pertaining to army men, naval men, married men who can sustain a battle injury and on it. Then there are several relations. First we'll go to unprivileged will. Unprivileged must be written and duly signed, and testimonium should be there. Indian Succession Act deals with execution of the will, the privileged will, unprivileged will, and how to get a letter of probation, and how to get a letter of administration, what to do, what not to do, all those things are there. But so far Muslims are concerned, Muslim the persons belong to Muslims are concerned, and if the will is executed, they can go for probation or letter of administration. But there are certain restrictions that more than one third be bequeathed to the their own shareholders. The Muslim law succession says sharers, distant kinders, and residuaries. When the property is being divided, the son is not mentioned as one of the sharers, because he take all the leftover property after giving shares. That is the methodology of the Quranic verses. So far Muslims are concerned, this is there, but we are not concerned with the Shia sect. There is some little bit difference between Shia sect and Sunni sect. So still the Muslim also can invoke Indian Succession Act for letter of probations, challenging all those things. Now, what is the way of execution of will? That the person should be on good state of mind, good health, may not be a lunatic, and he should understand what is the contents of the will. Then that should be executed in presence of the two witnesses. Suppose if one of the executant is Pardanashini lady, that means a Muslim who were not allowed to go outside and show her face. So the person who acquainted with her must certify that it was she who signed the will. Like that, blind persons also, because they may not be in a position to read the contents of the will, somebody should read out to him, and after having understood the contents, he should show the place where he must sign, and that he should attest. So these things are there. So first of all, if you are not party to the will and you are not getting the share, or you are not agreeing to the share as per will, you can file suit for declaration stating that that will executed is a sham, null and void, all other things, and thereafter you file suit for partition. Suit for partition. So prior to that, you have to issue notice to the all legal heirs. So far will is concerned, partisanship is concerned, you must be acquainted with the succession. If it's Hindu section provisions of male Hindu dying intestate, if the female dying intestate rule of law, and if it's a Muslim rule of succession, if it's a Christian rule of succession. And there are disparity in Christian law and Muslim law. So far, shares allotted to the woman are concerned. But since Hindu succession prior to 1956 was highly dominated by male opponents, but however they keep women folk as their wealth and luxuries, therefore there may not be any rise against their claim, but they are protected by maintenance, they are protected by sridhanas, they are protected that she is given in marriage, lot of facilities were there. That system now being disturbed even after 2005 Amendment Act and Indian Succession Act, it is totally disturbed. Okay, then letter of probation means if the executant of will nominate somebody to implement the will, so he has to apply for letter of probation. See, the compulsory obtaining letter of probation, letter of administration is available only for the when the property is situated at notified cities. Otherwise, you can go to civil court and act upon, that is called act upon execution of will by local understanding or family understanding. Otherwise, what to do if you are receiving a summons from the court that somebody filed a letter of administration or a letter of probation, grant of probation? You have to file, enter your appearance. Thereafter, you have to file citation stating that I intend to object to the grant of letter of probation. Then automatically, the TOP, testamentary original petition, filed before either High Court or before the district courts, be renamed as TOS, testamentary original suit. Then thereafter, all the procedures available under CPC. So the original application filed for grant of letter of administration or grant of probate be treated as plaint. You have to file written statement, then issues will be framed and it will tried, and subsequently there is appeal, OSA, so many things, LPA are there. There were so many things are there. But if you have not filed your, you have not entered your appearance, or you have not filed your citations, then automatically letter of administration or grant of probation will be given to the person who applied for as per the will. But you all keep in one mind, my dear friend, that the grant of letter of probation or grant of letter of administration itself does not confer title to the persons whose favor the will was executed. Still you can challenge your share, because sometimes what happens, the father, thinking that he is absolute owner of the property, may bequeath the will to his sons and others, excluding his daughters or one of the sons against whom he have some hatred. Still you can challenge, you can file suit for partition stating that my father have no right, legal right to execute the entire property because it is an ancestral property. He is having his share only. Only that share will devolve on the person for whom the property was bequeathed by execution of the will. Then you will have your share. And your father's share will again devolve on all the sons and daughters, and there will be a fraction of property. It may not be as per the will executed by the the executant of bill. That is most important, you should concentrate on that. Then question arises, if you want to dispute the execution of the will itself, you have to lead evidence, because only after expiry of the person who executed the will, the trial commences. You have to execute a will by securing documents, by witnesses who could come and speak that the executant of will was not a better state of mind. He was under undue influence, coercion and opportunity. Opportunity means the person who suppose attending the person who executed the will before his last breath, then you see he may take advantage for execution of the will, and the person may not be in a better position to express his feeling, because his life and care is at the hands of the person who is looking into his affairs of the health and the safety. So that cross-examine the witnesses who speaks about the signing of the executant at the time of execution of the will. You can say, do you know what is contents of the will? Do you know how many family members are there? All these things are there. And then you can also can say that will must have qualifications and disqualification, and should disclose all the legal errors, first class legal errors. See, first class, there is no first class legal, all the other second class legal errors in the said will. That shows the state of mind, what he has done with a diligent and a due care and with a conscious of mind. So that should be taken into account. So that part may also, you can, what is qualification, disqualification? If he is having 3 sons and 4 daughters, he must disqualify why he is not bequeathing his property to this legal heir, stating that I have already spent a huge amount, I have already settled the property, or he is not taking care of that, he is not leading normal moral life. All this disqualification, that this person is looking after me, is feeding me, is taking to the doctors and hospitals whenever I am sick and indisposed of. All these would have the knowledge of quality. So if there is no testimonial witness was available, then the person who wrote the will may be examined, that it was I who wrote the will, or I who typed the will as dictated by the executant of will. Then other thing, the advocate who sometimes signs, or the professional writer may sometimes signs at the end of the will, heldi tayate, written and drafted by so and so, he may also be executed for proof of the will. Same time, to contradict their evidence and witness, you have to say that at what time you were there, when they were brought, when he was brought, by what vehicle, whether there was a supporting person who carried him, whether he is a better state of work. Sometimes what happened, the executive himself straight away go to the advocate and dictate in, because he was ill and healthy. All these things are there. Therefore, it is most important that you should concentrate all aspects, and you go through the Indian Succession Act. Law of interpretation, law of construction, two things are different. When the court gives actual understanding of the word in any act or provisions, that is called interpretation of law. But if any document contains some patent error or latent error, that may be construed, that is called construction. For law of construction, you can get material and provisions only under Indian Succession Act. If suppose the executor of the will declares that the so-and-so property, B schedule property, go to Maria, my daughter, and there may not be a Maria daughter, probably a granddaughter is there. Therefore, that the, all these explanations, multi number of explanations are there under Indian Sections Act. Kindly take care of that. Go through it deeply. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Best wishes.